The KMT is facing renewed pressure to revive its image following the DPP's victory in the Kaohsiung mayoral by-election last weekend. Reports suggest that some KMT officials would like to see the party chairman Johnny Chiang replaced.
When Chiang was asked about the rumor on Tuesday, he shrugged off the suggestion that rebellion is brewing in the party.
In his first public outing since the KMT lost Kaohsiung, Chiang signs a petition vowing to spearhead the campaign for referendums to be bound to elections. He hopes it will be voted on next August. After the Kaohsiung defeat, some are saying the KMT's will to reform is inadequate. There are even rumors that a coup is brewing to topple Chiang.
Everyone is very interested in this. Thank you. At this moment in time, the KMT will not let people use any excuse to get at us. Thanks. We'll have another re-election, and then next year another re-election. The KMT can't stand all this division. It doesn't have the capacity to elect another party head at this point in time. So I think the people who are mouthing off about getting rid of Chairman Chiang are actually mostly people who really want to hurt the KMT.
The party's youth wing is standing by Chiang, as are successive new Taipei mayors Eric Chu and Ho Youyi.
We have always thought there are some less than ideal things that everyone believes should be changed. We must face what needs to be faced. We must accept the challenge if we want to represent the will of the people. For the KMT, gaining more support is our objective and our direction. Today, no matter which societal group you're part of, which demographic or community, we want to win your support. That's how it was in the past, and that's how it will continue.
The KMT's efforts to reform in line with a changing Taiwan are an unprecedented test for the party's leaders.